All right, welcome to What's in My Bag in Hollywood at Amoeba. I'm Chris Myers, by the way, from Fox Sports. So I cover Super Bowls, NASCAR, football, baseball, you name it. So here's what's in my, some of the things that I grabbed here. It's hip to be square. It's hip to be square. But I'm a big fan of comedy. And growing up, I mean, I had Don Rickles. I had the album Hello Dummy, which is over there as well. And Don Rickles is still going today. He's entertaining, and it reminds me of, you know, sitting in my room listening to a guy just rip on everybody.
You know how I spent my day off? With Ed Sullivan. You know how exciting that is? It's watching a casket warp.
Everybody was insulted equally. I used it on my brothers and sisters. It was great comedy, and so I thought, you know, having something like this, I'd like my kids to hear, although it's politically incorrect today, some of that stuff. And Henny Youngman.
Now you take my wife, please. My wife is never happy with the housework. I bought electric iron, electric dishwasher, electric dryer. She said too many gadgets around the house, she had no place to sit down. What did I do? Bought her electric chair.
Just old style one-liner deliveries that come in handy at dinner parties. I still use some of that material. I mentioned I covered NASCAR. The movie Bullet, the first great chase scene, and Steve McQueen was terrific, but I come from a family of Ford lovers, so the Ford Mustang beat the Dodge. But the chase scene alone is worth, you know, picking this up. So it's nice to kind of find this. That's something you don't see every day. The movie Bullet with Steve McQueen. Also, Bridge on the River Kwai. My father, I watched this with my father growing up. He served in World War II. He passed away recently. He was in the Normandy invasion. It was a movie about great courage, tough decisions, men who devote their careers to something. Nobody really wins, and people's lives are torn apart. Great sacrifice, confusion. Bill Holden, a terrific movie. Great music in that as well. This brought back childhood, and my kids watch with me every time they come on. Sometimes we have marathons in LA where channels play Twilight Zones around the clock, and I have a lot of these already, but there are some episodes in particular, The Obsolete Man with Burgess Meredith.
The board finds you obsolete.
Your rights are as follows, Mr. Wordsworth. You are to be liquidated within a period of 48 hours, but you have an option as to method and precise time.
One for the Angels, where a guy, his death goes to take him, and he has to make a pitch to save a young girl.
It's 11:45, in 15 minutes, midnight. That's my appointment.
Mr. Death, that little girl's only 8 years old. I'm ready now.
I'm sorry, Mr. Bookman, but I had to make other arrangements. It's impossible to change them now.
So these never get old to me. It's like the Honeymooners. I you can sit down and watch them, even if I've seen them and can quote the lines. My kids grew up watching them, and it's as if they're still on TV on a regular basis. So I just wanted to make sure I grabbed the right copy here. The changing of a guard reminded me actually of a teacher who's about to retire. And he's past his time, and he contemplates ending his life, but he thinks back, and the appearance of all the people whose lives he affected keeps him in good spirits as he steps down. So it made me think about a lot of the teachers and people who influenced my life. Twilight Zone had that kind of impact. And just a couple of other things to the music side, and I can go crazy music-wise, and I'm a big greatest hits guy because I like all in one place. Barry White. First concert I ever saw down in Miami with my sister, with her boyfriend, took me, and I think we were the only white people there. But he had made such an impact on me, that a feel for soul or funk, whatever you want to call it. So from Barry White, I always like listening to his music. And, you know, it's always good with the ladies as well. Not to name drop, but he's a big sports fan. Got to meet Huey Lewis. We've hung out together, played some golf. He's had my kids backstage at some of his concerts. To me, defines rock and roll. He's super cool. He's like the Steve McQueen of music.
They say the heart of rock and roll is competing. And for what I've seen,
and he should be in the Hall of Fame, by the way, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I can't believe that he's not. But hopefully one day he will be. And his greatest hits. Also, he was breakthrough in music videos. Probably sell those in here somewhere too. Music videos, which I would love to get a hold of, because that was a certain era that reminds me of Huey Lewis and his music, and you know, the sports album, of course, which kind of figures in with me. So those are some of the things that I have in my bag here at Amoeba.